Hi, Suzanne Stoddard here for Legitimate Affiliate Training, and today I want to review Opus Clip. This is an awesome software that I use every day to create shorts for my YouTube channel. This software is brilliant. It's a great way to repurpose your long videos into multiple short ones, whether you're using them as YouTube shorts or anywhere else that you post your videos on. So from just one long video, you can get 5 up to 10 shorts. One time I even got 11. So stay with me, okay? Because I'm going to show you inside my own account and show you just how powerful this is. Okay, so let's dive deep into Opus Clip. On their website here, it tells you how you can get 10 viral clips from one long video. And sometimes you get more, sometimes you get less. It depends on how long your long video is. And these are all the powerful features that it has. So we're going to go through one by one, and I'll show you inside what they're talking about. So the AI curation is the AI analyzes the video, identifies its most compelling hooks, and extracts the highlights from different parts of your video, rearranges them together into cohesive viral short videos. So this is inside my account here. And as you can see, these are just some of the videos that I've been creating shorts with. Now you have an option of either dropping your YouTube video link here or Vimeo or wherever it is that your video is hosted, or you can drag and drop your file from your computer. So I have one here that I have to do. So I'm going to drag it onto the screen and just drop. And it's proceeding to upload the video so that the AI can start working on it. Now this is going to take a couple of minutes, so I'm going to pause and I'll be right back. And there we go. So the video is fully uploaded. It tells you how long the video is, 8 minutes, 50 seconds. And you can save your credits if you know that you only want to access maybe the first half of the video. You can move the slider to wherever you want. Now I usually keep this on auto, but if you have a preferred length, again, you can click on under 30 seconds, 30 to 60, 60 to 90, 90 to 3 minutes. And then you can add keywords to make sure that your clips are going to be based on the topic that you want it to be. Now, granted, your whole long video should be on the one topic, but just in case. So my video is about how long it takes to make money online and passive income. And I'm going to leave it at that and click the blue button. Now, it'll tell you if their server is really busy. Here it's saying that it's experiencing high demand and I'm zero in queue, and that the waiting time is about 20 minutes. So I can leave this page and it'll email me when it's done. Now, I've never had to wait this long. Usually I'm waiting only about 5 minutes. But again, instead of having you wait with me, I'll be right back. Oh, and here you go. See, it's already fetching the video. They're down to 6 minutes wait time. Again, it's not going to be 6 minutes, but I'll be right back. And there we go. It gave me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It gave me 11 shorts from that one long video that was between 8 and 9 minutes. And this is what I mean by on the sales page. The AI curation is their clip genius technology that does all this with just one click. The next thing down here is the AI virality score. So what this means is it shows the potential of each short clip. The score is based on the AI's analysis on thousands of viral videos. So it shows you how well your videos could do in the short form. So of course, the higher the better, right? So this would be the first one I'd use because it's a score of 99. It explains to you here what it did. It uses a hook sentence to grab the viewer's attention and makes them curious. And then it flows logically. And if you click on the text here, it shows you the text portion that it took out of your video. Also on the sales page, The next thing it says is it has an AI copilot. Now, I showed you this in the beginning. This is where you can select the specific time frame you want, and you can look for specific parts of your clip based on the keywords that you give it. And the next thing is called active speaker detection. So the AI analyzes moving faces and ensures that your face is in the center of the video frame. Now notice that if there's two people, it will pick up both people, or if you're one above the other, or side by side. And I'll show you inside how that can be done. So if you click on edit, and you'll notice that my face is in the center of the video. If I were to come up here and click on design, and as I scroll down, I have the layout setting as automatic, but if you wanted to split the screen with someone else, you could choose to have three people or four. But of course, if you just set it to auto, it's going to automatically pick up what it needs to have your video look really good. Now, before I continue editing, let's go back and I want to show you what else it says here. It has an AI keyword highlighter. Again, you can have that set automatically where the captions are highlighted according to what you set it to or what the AI feels should be highlighted. And it says that when you highlight keywords like that, it can increase the watch time by 65%. And it also has an emoji generator. So that means that, again, it will automatically pick emojis to put under the text, again, to make your video more interesting. And they have researched and said on average, emojis increase views by 42%. So this is great. You don't even have to think about this. It does it automatically. And when you scroll down here, it talks about all the different things that it can do. So let me cover these inside. We'll go back to caption. And like I said, right here, this is where it starts the video. And it takes all of this down to here. And these are the keywords that it highlighted for you. Now this video is 31 seconds long, so it can be longer if you want to use it for a short. You can do it up to 60 seconds. So you can decide if you want to backtrack, and we can start at this sentence here, and you can set this as start. So it'll change that for you. And then as you go down, there might be something else you want to add here to keep this video in context. And I choose to leave it right here, and I'm going to set that as the end. So it's going to adjust this for me. The video is up to 43 seconds long, so you could choose more if you want to. You just have to make it relevant, okay? And you can also decide if you want to highlight other keywords. So if I wanted to highlight the word cash, I would just click on a color, and that turns green. Now I'll show you later in your branding template how you can change those colors if you want. And I'm going to click on this word and highlight this one green. So you can change it like this with your highlighted colors. I showed you how you could extend the length of the video by picking up other sentences. And this will automatically remove any filler words. Words like ah. You know, those types of things that we typically say when we create a video. Now, in this case, it's showing no filler words, but that's because I edited this video and took them out myself before I uploaded it. But you don't have to. It'll do it for you. And then if we go into design, this is where you can choose other things for this particular video. Now, I have this set up as my brand template, so all of my videos will be set according to what I've set here. You can choose 3 lines per page or 1 line. Now, I chose 3 lines per page, so some of the clips might have 3 lines here, and if you wanted to stick to just 1 line, then you would choose the other. The caption position, I again set to auto. But if you want all of your captions to be in either the top, middle, or bottom, you can choose that. You can have a screen overlay. So I uploaded my logo here into this software. So my logo shows up on all of my videos. You can set it to whatever font you like. Okay, so there's quite a few selections in here. You can choose the weight of it. Okay, whether you want it bold, regular, that type of thing. The font size, if you want italics or underlined. And here you have a choice of whether you want it all uppercase or not, okay? I tend to keep it all uppercase. And this is your font color. I typically have mine set as white because there's a lot going on in the background. The font stroke is the little bit of black you see around each letter. Again, you can adjust the thickness if you want. Okay, that's up to you. And you can shut this off as well. You can also remove any shadows. I tend to leave it the way it's automatically set because I do like the look of it. And this is where you can set your highlight colors. If you want your highlight a specific color, you would have to know what it is and you can put it in here. Or if you want to match your background, click on the eyedropper. Come here and click on the color you want to choose. And there you go. It'll suddenly match with your background. Now I'm going to leave it where it was because I find that these particular colors stand out the best along with the white. Again, here's your layout setting. If you want to change it to show other features of the video, again, I always keep this on auto. You can have an auto intro caption, and that's the caption that it gave you when it created the video. So if we come back here to the beginning, you can see that it added the title of the video to the beginning. Now, I usually don't like this because I start speaking right away in this video and I want people to be able to read the first things that I'm saying. And if you don't want any emojis, you can toggle this off as well. So that's for the design. If you find that there aren't enough emojis in here, so you would click on a word. Click on this icon here, add emoji. And that was the word money. So let's see what it comes up for money. And it has all of these options. So I'm going to choose this one here. I'm going to double click. And here we go. See, it's popped into the sentence. And I'm going to move it down because it did appear behind the text. So you can bring it down and you've got an emoji. So you can go in here and add as many as you want. Interest. Once you're all done, click Save and Compile, and it brings you back to your dashboard. And you can see here how it's editing the video over again. It's almost like water filling up in a glass. So you'll kind of get an idea of how long it's taking. It doesn't take long at all. And you can do that with each and every video to your heart's content. You can also auto-post them to your social media accounts. Now I have this hooked up to my YouTube account so I can automatically post from there. You can also do TikTok, Instagram Reels, and LinkedIn. Let me show you the brand template that I was talking about. If you click on your image and click on brand template, this shows you what I've already set up for myself. So I did choose the 3 lines per page. You could choose the 1 line if you wanted, something on just the top, the middle, the bottom. Okay, that's up to you. This is where I uploaded my logo. I chose this particular font because that's what I like. I like to have all of my text in uppercase. Again, the white font with the black stroke and shadow. It just seems to show up the best on most backgrounds. And the highlight color. So you can set all of this to whatever you like, okay, the automatic emojis, whether or not you want that intro caption. And once you've got it set the way you like, you can save the template. Now, this is already saved, so it's not going to show up here. So let's say I changed this to 1 line. See, now I can save the template. And you also have a choice of creating 5 templates in all. So this is a great way to save you the work of editing each and every video. You just have to pick your brand, and that particular set of videos would all be done according to that preset template. The other thing in here is your credit usage history, the subscription plan that you have, and log out. Now, if you have any questions, just clicking down here in the bottom right-hand corner, it gives you a lot of help. Okay, they have a lot of articles. They'll show you what's new. And what I like about this is that it shows you their change log, and they are consistently improving this product. It's amazing what they've brought in over this last 6 months, okay? And they will also take your suggestions. If you have any requests, you can put it in here, and they'll take it under review. I had asked a question if I could add an end scene to my clips so I could have a call to action. They answered me right away and said, no, they don't currently have that feature, but it sounded very interesting and it's something that they want to consider. And then the help button, again, they have different sections for you to go to about a specific issue. And if you need to talk to someone, you can set up a free Discord account, okay? It's really easy to use this. And they have all of these different sections if you have any questions to ask. I was in here just the other day, and I had an immediate response to my questions. So it's really nice for that quick reply instead of waiting for an email. So just to show you what you get when you sign up, let's click on pricing. And they do offer a free forever plan. You would get a free trial to start with, and it gives you 90 minutes of upload time, and then you can download up to 60 minutes of your short videos. And once you've used up all of those minutes, you're put automatically on the free forever plan. But the only downside to that is that you have some limited features, okay? You don't get to use everything that I showed you, meaning that after those 7 days, the clips will no longer be viewable or exportable. And then your clips will have a watermark showing that it was Opus Clip that created it. So if that doesn't bother you, then you can stay on the free forever plan and you're given 60 minutes at the start of every month that you can use up again. I would just suggest that you download your clips right away because it'll only stay in your account for a week. But the nice thing that they're offering right now is this yearly plan. If you sign up, their smallest plan is $19 a month, which is still a great price for everything that it does. And it can go up from there if you need more minutes, okay, depending on the size of your business. But if you choose the yearly plan, you get a 50% discount. So that brings the monthly cost down to $9.50. So if you pay $114 one time for the year, you're immediately uploaded with 2,400 upload minutes, and what you don't use gets carried over. And then, of course, there are larger plans from there, again, depending on the size of your business. And here they're coming up with a pro plan in December. And if you decide to choose that in December, your credits will be automatically transferred over, depending on what you haven't used. Now, I used up my 90 minutes very quickly, so I jumped on this 50% discount right now because for $114 a year, for me, it is very worth it. So there you go, guys. I consider this software to be a one-click wonder. It's just amazing how I can repurpose my long videos into shorter clips to use over and over again. I personally use them as YouTube Shorts, but you can use them anywhere where you embed a video. And everything is automatic, one click. It's nice to see a software that actually works in one click when they say it does. So I highly encourage you to try this out. Like I said, you can have the free forever plan as long as you want, but if you're like me, you're going to want to jump on that 50% discount while they're offering it. So thanks so much for watching my review video. I hope you found it useful. And if you did, would you please subscribe to my channel? And don't forget to hit like under the video. If you have any other questions or comments about Opus Clip, just leave them below and I'll get right back to you, okay? So until my next video, cheers.